June 22nd, 2018, regarding the Project MEDI, City of Elk Grove, response to RFI, Elk Grove Medical and Biotech Center. Dear Barry, the City of Elk Grove is pleased to provide a response to the above-mentioned RFI issued by the Greater Sacramento Economic Council. The city understands the client is a pharmaceutical manufacturing company that wants to establish a facility for manufacturing sterile injectable products for the global market. Additionally, we understand the project consists of approximately 6 acres of land to build a 130,000 square foot facility that will represent an estimated total investment of $33 million and total employment of 204 jobs. After reviewing the search and site criteria, we have 3 exceptional sites to offer in Elk Grove for this project. The sites are all part of an emerging biotechnology and medical campus known as the Elk Grove Medical and Biotech Center, which is anchored by an existing fully accredited medical and pharmacy school, California North State University, CNU. CNU is one of only 10 medical schools in California and only the 4th California school in the state to include accredited medical and pharmacy degrees on the same campus. CNU is rapidly expanding with plans to add dental and clinical psychology degrees in the near future and the development of extensive additional teaching, medical research, and manufacturing facilities. As part of that expansion, CNU, Greater Sacramento, and the city are working together to develop a world-class biotech park located on or adjacent to CNU's campus, representing an exceptional location for biotech companies to locate. The biotech center will include research, wet lab, manufacturing, office, and startup facilities for startup and more established companies and research institutions seeking to benefit from the synergy between a biotech park and a quickly growing medical teaching and research school. The center is ideally located on the west side of Elk Grove along Interstate 5, approximately 90 minutes from Silicon Valley and San Francisco, Oakland, and is comprised of affordable greenfield development sites benefiting from willing public and private partners. The City of Elk Grove is 100% committed to working with you and the proponents of Project MEDI to facilitate the relocation of this company. The Elk Grove City Council and staff are completely committed to growing the city's and the regional economy.
Kathy Engel.
Okay, Elk Grove City Council and staff are completely committed to growing the city's and the region's economy, and as such, we are in a position to develop a package of technical assistance and financial incentives proportional to the capital investment and employment impact of the project. So if you can see, how do I get to the next page? There we go. So these locations, the location that on Maritime, this was actually not owned by Alvin at that time. This information was shared with only a select few people, and in fact, it was not shared with the owner of that property. So the owner of that property sold it for probably less than she would have sold it for had she known. So now she is probably going to sue Elk Grove because it wasn't Alvin buying it, it was the city trying to bring people in. So the city's involved, so there's another lawsuit that we all get to pay for. And I'll finish up here. City assistance. All phases of the project will receive red carpet services to expedite all necessary government approvals under the city's Economic Development Project Review Team Program. Subject to terms to be negotiated, the city is capable of providing a financial incentive package for the project, including from but not limited to, which doesn't make sense, the following programs. And then it goes on to list, the fund's direct subsidy from the city's adopted economic development incentive program. A typical incentive structure may include an upfront amount followed by an annual amount per job created. There are some other things that list that are, I guess, typical things that they offer. And But the FAS plan review, the city guarantees a 10-day turnaround for the first set of plan review comments. This is a pharmaceutical manufacturing, too. And issues TI and new construction building permits on average in 7 days. Permit simplicity allows businesses to obtain a tenant improvement permit for an existing building in 1 day. PASS, pre-qualified architectural submittal system, is the city's program that speeds building permit issuance through the use of pre-qualified and certified architects and engineers. So I don't know if any of that is happening on this other project, but what I would like to say is the fact that Barry Broom knew about this, Daryl Doan did tell us that he frequently keeps things confidential, but apparently Barry Broom is like on the inside. Maybe I wanted to buy that property and make a bunch of money because I knew a hospital was going there. That would have been awesome. So there's another thing, just one more thing we keep finding about what's wrong with this and how nobody told the people that live in this city. Barry Broom knows more than we do.
Kathy, I'd like to give you just a nickel's worth of free advice.
Okay.
There is no there on what you just read. Okay, I applaud everything about that letter. That's exactly what Daryl Doan should be doing. He should be working in concert with Barry Broom in order to improve the economic development of the region. And it is completely unrelated to the hospital. So if you have issue with the hospital coming forward or how that project is being handled, that's an issue. But to keep drudging up these ancillary things that is what our economic development director is paid to do, exactly what that letter says. So I think you're trying
secret projects is that so that people don't get what they should get for their land because other people get to buy it first. Is
then
that
they're a bad business person? The land should have been appraised and the sales price should have been agreed to. That's a civil contract. That has nothing to do with the city. We didn't influence that in any way.
If certain people knew about this project Medi and other people didn't, how is that okay?
So if you don't want to heed what I'm saying to you, that's fine. But that's what that position is paid to do, is to drum up those kind of opportunities.
The whole idea behind Barry Broom and the GSEC is to market this region, right? Centene, which is a Fortune 500 company, they ended up in Natomas. I promise you the similar process was made by their economic development director providing potentially suitable sites. This is up to the company, whoever this was. I didn't see this, even though I noticed at the bottom it's copied on city council, but I will tell you right now, I did not see this. I just asked Councilman Vice Mayor Hume. He's never seen it either.
Can we ask if anybody else saw it? No?
My point to you is this. He is marketing these sites. It is up to that company to then talk to these sites and call them up and say, hey, we'd like to be in your area because we understand what's going on. That's the business, the private side that happens. So Mr. Doan is trying to kickstart something. That's what Vice Mayor is alluding to. But the rest of it is a private transaction. We don't even know who this company is. You know, this is between Barry and because Barry will receive leads, and I'll defer to you, Mayor, since you sit on the council. But my understanding is Barry will receive leads that we don't know about, and that they'll do these things. And they often do this because companies don't want everybody knowing that they'll come to town. The thing that Amazon did, this is a very unique situation, but Amazon publicly across the nation asking to bid and submit proposals, that's not what typically happens. So This was advertising our city in the best light possible. You heard business, you know, processes to get your permits and things, trying to highlight that we're a business-friendly city and trying to market potential sites. I trust in other situations he'll market SEPA, the Southeast Policy Area, as well. But there's a lot of then private transactions that need to happen after that. So this is only, you know, the beginning of something. That's all I can tell you. I mean, this isn't about alluding to any specific project. And the mention of California North State, they are a medical school, which I can tell
They bought that property. You know that.
They
right?
did now, yeah. But I mean, when did
they
this was in 2018?
Before they made the announcement.
No, I'm saying this letter was from 2018.
Right, but the property owner didn't get this letter. She never heard of it.
Well,
anyway.
I'm a bad liar.